We are working the fallout tonight from our latest campaign 2014 debate.
Last night, you saw Rhode Island's top candidates for governor face off live here on WPRI 12 and on WPRI.com.
And today, we caught up with them back on the campaign trail to see how they felt about the debate. Eyewitness News reporter Steve Nielsen joins us now live with the details that are new at 5.
Well, Mike Shannon, this is a tight race between the top two opponents. Just a slim lead right now for Gina Raimondo, according to our last poll. So it means everything was on the line last night. The last Eyewitness News Providence Journal debate of this campaign season went out with a bang. 24 hours later, I asked each candidate how they felt the debate went.
I think we need to be able to confront each other so that we can get ideas out there rather than talking about each other's television commercials.
I'm very excited about the debate. Had an opportunity to really, get my points across about what I want to do.
I offer a comprehensive jobs plan to get Rhode Island back to work and rebuild the middle class. And my opponent offers reckless tax cuts.
After the dust settled, emails poured into our newsroom from Democrats and Republicans challenging what Alan Fung and Gina Raimondo claimed. First, the Democratic Party says Fung lied. Fung says he never campaigned with former Governor Don Cachiri. But the Democratic Party claims Cachiri was there when Fung accepted an endorsement from Mitt Romney.
He was there with you, though, during the Mitt Romney announcement.
No, but he wasn't campaigning, and this is where there's a big distortion in the facts by the Democratic Party.
A pro-life group says that Raimondo contradicted herself on her late-term abortion stance. This all stems from when Raimondo accepted Planned Parenthood's endorsement. So I asked for her clear stance.
I have concisely stated my position numerous times, and it hasn't changed. I am pro-choice. But I also would support a ban on late-term abortions that have a provision for life and health of the woman.
Now, coming up at 6 o'clock, I questioned the candidates about a WPRI.com report that broke this morning. Hundreds of thousands of dollars from super PACs came pouring into this race within the last 24 hours. I'm Steve Nielsen, Eyewitness News.
Count on Eyewitness News for continuing coverage of campaign 2014.
And check out WPRI.com for important voter resources to help you make an informed decision on Election Day.